Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV with another Photoshop quick tip. If you've ever been frustrated with the clumsy roundness of the strokes placed around your text, well, fret no more. I'm going to show you how to make the strokes' corners sharp as a razor blade. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N, or by going to File and New. You can make it any size and resolution. I'll make the background black so it'll be easier on our eyes. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font that has sharp corners. We'll adjust its size in a moment. I'll make the color white so I can see it clearly on the black background. Click on your document and type out your text. To adjust its size, highlight it and drag the text size icon to the right. Let's increase the space between characters to make room for a thick stroke around each character. To do this, press and hold Alt or Option as you press the right arrow on your keyboard. Open your Move tool and drag the text to the center. Right-click or secondary click on the text layer and click Convert to Shape. Open your Path Selection tool. Click the Fill Color box, and for now, click the Null box, which fills our text with no color. Click the Stroke box and pick any color. I'll increase the stroke to 40 pixels so we can easily see it. Open the Stroke Options panel. There are three choices of strokes from which to choose: solid, dashes, and dots. The Align option allows us to choose the position of the stroke relative to its path. Basically, we can choose to make our stroke centered over the path, be inside the path, or be outside the path. We'll go over the Caps option in a minute. For the corners, we can make them rounded, mitered, or beveled, which creates squared corners. If you're using dashes or dots, the Align and Corners affect them in the same way. The Caps option specifies the appearance of both ends of a path. The Butt cap creates squared ends that abut or stop at the endpoints. The Round cap creates semicircular ends, and the Projected cap creates squared ends. The same effects apply to the stroke's corners. The More options allows us to adjust the dashes and dots, lengths, and gaps. Have fun experimenting with the dashes and dots, and if you want to fill the inside of your text, click the Fill box and pick a color. To hide the work path, just press Ctrl or Command H. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.